We are under the lights this evening as we get you set for another edition of Baseball on the Show. A good matchup here for you tonight between the Cincinnati Reds and the Toronto Blue Jays. Nick Castellanos now. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. The 1-1 home. Hard liner, but picked up on a hop. And that's out number one. Next will be the designated hitter, Nick Senzel. His past history with Hyunjin Ryu.
He's 2-for-3.
The 1-1. Is looked at for ball number two. Easy take there as the off-speed pitch misses well inside. There's Joey Votto as he gets ready in the on-deck circle. Got him reaching there. Strike two. Swing and a liner. Foul. One out, nobody on. Fouled away. And he's just going to make him throw as many pitches as he can as he fouls another one away, and it's still folded 3-2.
Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to go a little bit further outside the zone. Three foul balls in a row. He wants to get a swing and a miss on this next pitch.
And that's the second out. Ready now for Cincinnati, Joey Votto. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. A little bit outside, 2-1. Hard hit ball to second. And this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single.
Batting four. The third baseman,
into the box, Eugenio Suarez. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. That misses, and we're even at 2-2. So a full count now.
Good running count right here. Three balls, two strikes, two outs, runner on first. He'll be off to the races on this pitch.
Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Lifted in the air toward the line and right, but this is going to wind up a foul ball. Another full count pitch home. A shot down the first baseline. And a diving effort there, but it'll come up empty. It's a base hit. The relay. And he's going to make it there. Barely, as he's into second base with a double.
The second baseman, Mike Moustakas.
To the plate now, Mike Moustakas. Not close with the off-speed pitch taken for a ball. 3-1.
This is a spot you like to be in as a good hitter. Runners in scoring position and count leverage in your favor.
Here's a swing and a miss at the off-speed pitch. It's a full count now, 3-2.
Definitely a big pitch coming up right here. He's going to be pumped if he can work his way out of this inning with the game still tied.
The payoff pitch. Fouled off. Votto on third. Suarez on at second with two down. Moustakas lets it go as he'll trot down to first on ball four. So the bases are loaded here. Two men gone. And up next, the former Philly shortstop, Freddie Galvis. A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. Here's the 1-2. And he comes back to get him. So a great job pitching out of it with the bases loaded. Standing in, Rowdy Tellez. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. The 1-2. Misses, ball two. And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2. Vladimir Guerrero Jr. will be next. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Oh, and he has some trouble with it. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely.
The third baseman, number 27.
At the plate now, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. offered at and missed. Here's the throw. It bounces, but he's out. Nice play there to pick the throw and put the tag on quickly. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. The 2-2 one more time. Hit hard on the ground to second, and that's through for a hit. Standing in now, Yordan Gurriel, and a breaking ball in the dirt that time for a ball. Comes back with the cut fastball for strike three called, and there are two down. Set to get his evening at the plate started to Oscar Hernandez. And it's been a real struggle for him with the bat so far this year, looking to get things turned around in a hurry. Here's a called strike on the curveball, 1-2.
He's looking pretty passive here, hitting with a chance to drive in a run. Gonna have to make something happen with two strikes now.
And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. And this one's in the dirt, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Now the payoff pitch home. Swing and oh my. Hit him with the hein. And gone up into the second deck.
Yeah, everyone in the stadium, including the guy in the mound, knew it was just a matter of time until this guy cranked one out of here. Well, that's the first one of the year, and many more are sure to follow.
Into the box now, Bo Bichette. Oh, that one got the pitcher. And they'll have no play as he reaches first base safely. In now, Brendel Gritcher. Just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul.
He got a mistake right there, but missed it. Can't foul that pitch off in a big spot. 0-2 count. Heater caught too much of the zone.
Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double.
Number 10.
So now to the plate, Reese McGuire. Hit down the third baseline. And this goes right past him. Oh, my. That might plate two. And the second run will score. It's now a 4-0 game.
Batting it, the center fielder, Billy McKinney.
Stepping in now, Billy McKinney. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. As a look, now the pitch. High in the air down the right field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. The 1-2.
Outside, that's a ball.
Yeah, and that splitter is normally the go-to pitch to this guy. But it really hasn't shown that good downward action that he usually has. He needs to get back to finishing it out front.
And it's fouled away. Here's another 2-2. On the eighth pitch of the at-bat is the one that finally does it as he wears him down and the inning is over. That'll bring in Philip Irvin, and they've got some work to do early on, down 4-0 already.
Lots of baseball left in this one as we're still early on, but you don't want to fall too far behind. They're already down by a bundle, and one of the things you want your leadoff guy to get on and set the table for the big boys to start driving in some runs.
And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now. Now this is hit high and deep out to left. Gone to lead off the inning.
When you're facing an elite starter, you know runs are going to be at a premium. I don't know if this shakes the starter's confidence, but you know what it does? It certainly boosts the confidence of the guys in your lineup.
Into the box, Aristides Aquino. Popped him up. McGuire is there. And that's the first out of the inning. Into the box now, Kurt Casale. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Taken, but called for strike two on the outer part of the zone. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. Line towards center field. McKinney is there now, and he has it. Two gone. Now Nick Castellanos at the plate now. Second appearance here. He grounded out to start the ball game. The 1-2 pitch. Swing and a liner. That gets down, and the inning continues.
Now batter number 15.
At the plate, Nick Senzel hit on the ground down the first baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Now a throw over to first, and he'll dive back in safely. The 2-2 pitch.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
And he misses here for ball four. Already two walks surrendered in his first couple of innings of work. So up steps the former MVP Joey Votto. A base hit in his first trip.
Yeah, and they take another single right here. That third base coach is dying to wave his arms. I wouldn't be surprised if anything hit hard through the infield. He's going to wave them.
Off-speed pitch misses here, and he runs it to 3-1.
There isn't a hitter alive that doesn't love hitting in fastball counts like 3-1. It's usually a pretty fruitful count in terms of getting a pitch to drive.
He pops him up toward the left side of the infield. Guerrero is there to make the catch, and the inning is over. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Next to bat for Toronto, Kevin Biggio.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
2-1 the count. And the pitch. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Castellanos arranged to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the first out. So it's back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring up Rowdy Tellez. 1-1. Bounce to the right into the loaded up infield. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. And he'll whip this one over to first, and he gets his man for the second out.
Now batting.
So bases are empty here with two gone, and Vladimir Guerrero Jr. settles in at the plate. And he fouls this one off. Two out, nobody on. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Fielded cleanly. Throw goes to Votto over at first. It's in time to retire the side.
We
leading off the inning, Eugenio Suarez, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
Hey, we're still in the early stages in this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
He throws him on the fastball there. Eugenio Suarez goes down for the first out here in inning number three. Pulled toward right center field. Grichuk will wait on it. And he's got it for out number two. In now for the Reds, Freddie Galvis, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And this is hit hard to the right side. Foul.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
Grounded up the first baseline. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Swung on, and he went fishing in the dirt. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. Bottom of the third now, stepping in for the Jays, Lourdes Gurriel, 0-for-1 after he took a look at strike three in his first plate appearance.
Yeah, in today's game, certainly don't get completely reprimanded for too many strikeouts, but no one likes to go down looking. Expect him to be a little bit more aggressive at the dish this AB.
Galvis is there, throw on to first, and one shortstop grounds out to the other, one away. So one away in the Toronto third. And striding into the plate next will be Teoscar Hernandez.
The last at bat, Matty D, we heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
And he'll put this away for the second out. So bases are empty here with two gone. And into bat next, the legacy, Bo Bichette. Here's the 1-1 pitch. On the ground to the left side. Reined in. Throw on to Votto will take care of him at first, and the side is retired. Stepping in, Philip Irvin. And he's off to a hot start in this one. Homered his first time around.
Yeah, that last at bat, Matty, he turned that fastball around. He didn't hit it a ton. He didn't hit it a country mile. But, hey, listen, a home run is a home run.
Throw to first in time, one gone here in the fourth. So digging in now, Aristides Aquino, 0-for-1 after a pop out in foul territory his first time through.
Yeah, Matt, he's got to make an adjustment right here. His swing definitely broke down, dropped his back shoulder, and thus the result was a terrible pop up foul.
On a line, that's a base hit into left field. Standing in now, Kurt Casale. Two balls and two strikes to the Reds catcher. And he lays off a pitch off the plate and high, 3-2.
We could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count.
And he goes with the pitch here and drives it the other way to deep right. But he's going to get there as he runs it down on the warning track for the second out of the inning. Back to the top of the Reds lineup now, and stepping in, Nicholas Castellanos. It was a single for him in his last at bat. He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
Nope. That's inside.
Four to one our score as we play inning number four. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. Ready now, Randall Grichuk. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at bat with another big hit right here.
And he's got to build off that last AB. He battled. Usually when you battle, you get in that swing mode. A lot of pitches, you'll swing at the rosin bag. I love the fact that he was able to work a double in last at bat. Let's see if we get more of the same right here.
a swing, and the barrel of the bat breaks in two that time. And safe, says the first base umpire, as the throw was too late.
The center fielder, number 28, Billy.
To the plate now, Billy McKinney. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact.
Man, he just missed the zone right there. One of the toughest pitches in the game, that backdoor cutter. As an offensive player, you give up on that pitch. As soon as it comes out of the hand, next thing you know, it's trying to grab the corner.
Digging in, Kevin Biggio comes into this at-bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. 1-2.
Great pitch in that situation. If he makes contact on that one, more than likely he's hitting into a double play.
And you can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two.
Number 44.
Four runs, seven hits, and no errors in the game for Toronto. And it's two balls and a strike to the Jays' leadoff batter. Hard liner to center field. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. Striding forward now is the DH, Nick Senzel. He's 0-for-1 thus far. The 2-2. Sent on the ground out to second. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away. In is Joey Votto now.
The first baseman, Joey Votto.
A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. Popped him up. And there's out number two. So now the Reds' cleanup hitter, Eugenio Suarez. It was a backwards K, a strikeout looking for him in his last at-bat.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system, especially now he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play. Hey, I don't mind that take right there. That was a nasty breaking ball. Started outside the zone, popped back inside the zone. Good spin rate on it. Move on to the next pitch.
And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. Set now for the bottom of the fifth. Settling in now, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. He got on top of one and was a ground-out victim last time. And here's a ball in the air now, carrying a bit out toward right center. Number 44 is there, and he'll bring this one in. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And that brings up the exciting Lourdes Gurriel Jr. A 1-1 home. Taken, strike two.
Can't say he's tickling around the zone. Those last two pitches were pretty much grooved right down the middle, but it didn't bite him.
Fouled away. Trying to send him packing for the second time. This is on the ground over to first. And he'll step on first for the out, three unassisted. So bases are empty here with two gone. And striding into the plate next will be Teoscar Hernandez. A ball and two strikes now. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Thomas Pannone will come on out of the bullpen as he'll be appearing in his third game this season. All set for the start of the inning. Riding in once again, Mike Moustakas. He flew out in his last at-bat. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Good break to that thing, and it's 1-2. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
There to play it is Grichuk, and that's the first out. Coming to the plate now, Freddy Galvis. He struck out twice thus far, so we'll see if he can fare any better here. Three balls and a strike to the shortstop of the Reds. Now a changeup just off the plate as that misses for ball four. Now to the plate, Philip Irvin. He was a ground-out victim last time up.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result. That's his last at-bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
Now the 2-1 pitch.
I love the approach out on the mound. Everything's down in the zone as it should be, but now you find yourself in a 3-1 count. Do you elevate a little bit more and get back in this zone, or you just pitch around it?
Hernandez is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. Stepping into the box, Aristides Aquino. Last time through was a base hit. Still a ball and two strikes. One run, five hits, and no errors in the game for Cincinnati thus far. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at-bat going. To two balls and two strikes now. Tried to fool him with the changeup, but he won't offer at it. 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away. Set, here's the 3-1. Full count now.
The Reds have been searching for that big hit all game long. Let's hope they can get it. They're starting to run out of time. It's about time for something to happen.
And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball. Sam Gaviglio takes the mound now, and it appears he's being brought in to face the right-handed batter who waits next.
Yeah, you usually don't hear the term righty specialist very often, but that's kind of how they're using him here, Matt. Most hitters have a harder time against pitchers of the same handedness, so we'll see if this move pans out.
Three balls and a strike to the Reds left fielder. Bonnie bailed him out with a swing, 3-2 now. Another full count pitch. Swing and he pops him up, and this should get him out of it. Biggio is there as he makes the catch, and they'll tightrope out of danger as he strands the bases loaded. Wade Miley will come on and make his fourth appearance in this campaign.
Number 22, Wade Miley.
Bottom of the sixth inning now. Coming forward now, the Toronto designated hitter, Bo Bichette. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. And he takes one off the inside corner for ball two. Ball three. Rendell Grichuk is on deck. And that one misses, so the leadoff man will head down to first on ball four to start the bottom of the sixth. So a runner at first now with nobody out. And the big right-handed bat of Rendell Grichuk saunters into the batter's box next. Down the first baseline, but a foul ball, 1-2 now. From the belt, the pitch. Lines softly toward the hole. That's in for a base hit, and he's 2-for-3. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Now batting, number 10.
In now, Reese McGuire. Yanked high and deep down the line in right. And it's a foul ball. Sixth inning, 4-1 is our score. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Down the third baseline. But this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. Tried to get him with the cutter, but it's a full count, 3-2.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher. But you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
Pulls this one into the air out into right field. Irvin is over to his left as he snags this one for the first out of the inning. And he'll move up to third now. Runners at the corners here with one away. That'll bring up Billy McKinney. And they're runners at the corners now. From the stretch. Runners are at first and third, one away. Not close with that one. It's way above the strike zone. Now a hard liner towards short. But this is pulled in by the shortstop. Now at the plate, Kevin Biggio. He's 0-for-2 with a strikeout in this one. Runners at the corners, two men out. One pitch and a nice call for the change. It's 1-2.
Hey, it's looking like he may be able to get out of this one after giving up two singles early.
Inside and a hair low. It's 2 balls and 2 strikes. Two pitches fouled away. Skied into very shallow right. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. And now the designated hitter for the Reds, Nick Senzel. Fouled straight back. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning. Now at the plate, Joey Votto. He's got a hit in 3 at-bats to this point. Ball low as he's able to lay off the slider.
Hey, there's not a lot you can do with a slider breaking down and in unless you catch it way out front. I like the idea of taking it and making the pitcher bring you something a little more hittable.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Eugenio Suarez. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
Now the 2-1. And there's a base hit on the line. And that runner will go no further than second as there are 2 aboard now.
The batter, the shortstop, Freddie Galvis.
Into the box now, Freddie Galvis. Swung on and missed, 1-2 now.
With runners on base, 2 outs and 2 strikes, this is a big next pitch for both sides.
Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. The 1-2 gets him swinging. He struck him out. Jose De Leon gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh.
Number 87,
Rowdy Tellez, the next to bat. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone. Vladimir Guerrero Jr. is on deck. Line toward right center. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
Now batter, number 27.
Into the box, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. He swings and misses. Throw down.
Right on the money, and he's cut down trying to take second base. The 1-2. Base hit, line drive into the corner. And this will find the wall deep in the corner. Throw into second. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two base hit.
Now batting. Not shortstop. Lourdes Gurriel.
So now to the plate, Lourdes Gurriel. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there. Fastball was too much for him there, swung right through it.
When you get yourself to a 3-1 count and you get a fastball, those are the ones you really want to punish. Couldn't get the bat on it, so we'll see if that comes back to haunt.
So that'll bring in Teoscar Hernandez. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Here's a pitch swung on and missed. 1-2 now. Now a ball grounded to short. This could be two. There's one. Relay to Votto's in time at first, and it's a double play. Side retired. Anthony Bass has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 52. Anthony.
Ready to begin the eighth at the plate, Philip Irvin. Perhaps he can drive another one out of the park just like he did back in the second. Hit on the ground out to short. He's got it. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number eight.
Now
stepping in, Aristides Aquino. He's 1-for-2 in this one. Eighth inning, 4-1 is our score. He loses him on ball four. Into the box now, Kirk Casale. 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Nip the corner, 2-2. A swing and a miss. He offered it a ball way outside the strike zone for out number two. So the batting order turns over now and set to go. Nicholas Castellanos. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. They try to come in with the fastball, but it's too far in, and it's even at 2-2. Throw over to first, and the runner back in standing. A runner on first with two away. Won't commit on the slider. Good patience, and it's full 3-2. Nick Senzel would be next. This one's flared out toward left. Coming in is Hernandez. He can't get there as it falls in.
Now batting. Number 15.
Standing in now, Nick Senzel. Left side. Scooped up. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Ready for another shot now, Bo Bichette. He's 1-for-2 in the ballgame. Here now the 2-2. Doesn't get the zone. Count full now. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. A ball that's carrying. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Now at the plate, Randall Grichuk. He steps in off a base hit in his last at-bat. Bases are empty, one man out. Now this is swung on, and here's another fly ball out to right field. Irvin is camped under this one, and that's out number two. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Reese McGuire. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. The 2-1 home. Line drive to center field, and that'll get down for a two-out single. So the bottom of the inning is still alive after the two-out base hit.
The center fielder, number 28, Billy.
Stepping in now, Billy McKinney. Changeup laid off down around the shins.
He's fallen behind now, 3-1. Three balls and two strikes to the Blue Jays center fielder. Strike three called, and the inning is over. Ken Giles comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth. Ready once again, Joey Votto. He'll lead things off against Giles as they're down to their final three outs in this ball game.
They look like they're up against it here, down three on the road, trying to come back against the closer.
No offer on that one, two balls and a strike. And he lays off again, ball three.
If you're at the plate in this situation, you're only thinking one thing, and that is get on base. You got three balls. It has to be perfect over those 17 inches for you to pull a trigger. A walk is as good as a knock right here.
A runner at first with no outs here. Down low, two balls and a strike.
Sometimes you got to be aggressive offensively, but sometimes you just let the pitcher dig his own grave. Patience and discipline seem to be the way to go right here.
And a swing and a miss. Does that look like self-defense there? It's 2-2. Here's a high pop-up. Tellez has a play. He's got it one away. So a runner at first now with one away. And up next, the former World Series hero, Mike Moustakas. One and two now.
Yep, 1-2.
Fouled off. The 1-2.
Ball two.
Runners on first with one down. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. Stepping up to the plate, Freddy Galvis, and he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. And that misses, 2-1. And it's fouled away. And now a crowd reported at over 28,000 rise to their feet. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
Well, the tying run looms on deck, so keeping this guy off the base is essential. In danger of walking him right here, though.
And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away. And a slider runs in on him as he has to lean out of the way. Winker in front, three balls and a strike.
Two on, two out with the base open here as a pitcher. You have to be awful careful. You just don't want to groove something here and give this guy a pitch that he can hit one out of the park on.
And he fouls this one off. The Reds down to their last strike. Now a swing and a ground ball. This should do it. Reined in. Throw on to first is going to be in time. And the Blue Jays have taken games one and two here at home as this one is over.
It's always nice to give your fans at home something to cheer about, and they definitely did that right here, coming through with a big win at home.
A 4-1 finish in this evening's game. The Toronto Blue Jays put up a four spot in the opening frame on the way to victory. Hyunjin Ryu gets the win on the mound, his first of the year. Ken Giles hammers down the save, his third of the campaign. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Fans, our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Blue Jays, 4 runs on 11 hits. No errors. They left 8 men on base. For the Reds, 1 run, 7 hits. No errors. They left 15 runners on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 56 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.